فتحيا حياة ما كما تلك حيوتي.
الحمد لله خلق الإنسان في أحسن تقويم.
All praise is due to Allah who has created the human being in the best of forms.
ودله على المنهج القويم.
And he has indicated to him the best of ways and paths.
والصراط المستقيم.
And the straight path.
وأرسل إلى هذه الأمة.
And he sent to this ummah.
نبيه الرؤوف الرحيم.
His gentle, merciful prophet.
فعظم شأن هذه الأمة.
And so the affair of this ummah has become great.
واعتلت مكانتها.
And its level and degree has enhanced.
باقتدائها بنبيها وصفيها محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
As it follows the example of the elect chosen prophet.
فكانت ذاته أكرم ذات.
And so his essence is the most honorable of essences.
وصفاته أعلى الصفات.
And his characteristics are the greatest.
وأخلاقه كريمة.
And his manners are the best.
وروحه رحيمة.
And his soul is merciful.
صلى الله وسلم عليه وعلى آله.
Peace and blessings of Allah be upon him.
ثم تفاوت الناس بعد ذلك في قربهم من النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على حسب ما اتصفوا به من صفاته.
And then depending on how much people embody the characteristics and manners of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, they will be nearer to him.
فاعتلت مكانة أهل المكانة.
So the people of high degrees will be raised.
بمعرفة مكانة التي أوجدهم الله تعالى فيها.
By understanding the degree that Allah Ta'ala has placed him in.
أنهم مكرمون.
Because they are honored and ennobled.
نفق الله تعالى فيهم روحه.
Allah Ta'ala has cast the soul into them.
وميزهم بالعقل.
And he distinguished them with an intellect.
ودلهم على الشرع والنقل.
And he indicated to them the sacred law.
فتنافسوا بعد ذلك فيما يقربهم من ربهم.
And they then competed with one another in that which is going to bring them closer to their Lord.
فكان ذلك الأمر يرجع إلى شيئين.
And so this matter returns to two things.
إلى التحلي بأنوار النبوة.
The first is to embody the prophetic lights.
وبصفة الفتوة.
And also to be a person of inward code and outward code of honor, فتوة.
هذه الصفة التي ضاعت على كثير من هذه الأمة.
It is this characteristic that has been lost in many in this ummah.
وهي صفة مشهورة.
And it is a well-known characteristic.
من قبل الإسلام.
From before Islam.
كانوا يتنافسون في الجاهلية على التفتي.
They used to compete with one another in the days of ignorance in becoming a person of chivalry or honor.
ولكن المعنى كان عندهم مختل.
However, they had a deficient meaning or understanding of this.
والعمل فيهم معتل.
And they had a deficient intellect in this.
لأن الشيطان استحكم عليهم.
Because Shaytan has taken control over them.
فكانوا يظنون أن الفتوة.
So they thought that futuwa was.
أن تكون جبارا.
That you be someone who is arrogant.
وقاهرا للخلق.
And forcing people to do things.
ومتسلطا عليهم.
And controlling their affairs.
وبطاشا بهم.
And someone who comes and is unjust to them.
وبادلا قوتك وشجاعتك في الظلم.
And showing your power and strength in unfairness.
فجاء الإسلام.
And so Islam came.
ليعدل هذه الموازين.
In order to rectify this scale.
فقبل من الخير ما كان في الجاهلية.
And so Islam accepted that which was of good in the days of ignorance.
وأقام التابعين له على ميزان الشرع النبوي.
And those that followed Islam, it refined them so that they were on a prophetic balance.
ولهذا قال صلى الله عليه وسلم خياركم في الإسلام خياركم في الجاهلية إذا فقهوا.
And for this reason, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, the best of you before Islam will be the best of you after Islam if indeed you comprehend.
ومن المعنى المشترك في الفتوة بين الإسلام والجاهلية.
And the common meanings between Islam and فتوة in جاهلية.
النجدة للآخرين.
Is to come and be generous to others.
والمساعدة لهم.
And to assist them.
والخدمة لحاجتهم.
And being in their service.
ثم أضاف بعد ذلك الإسلام لهذه الفتوات معاني.
And then Islam came and supplemented to these meanings others.
وذكرنا الله تعالى في الكتاب العزيز بأخبار كثير من الفتيان.
And Allah has informed us in the book of the Quran many of the stories of these young chivalrous people.
من الرجال والنسوان.
From the men and the women.
وهذه الفتوة ظهرت في حياة سيدنا إبراهيم بارزة.
And this fatwa or chivalry became manifest in the life of our Prophet Ibrahim.
عندما قام بصد ظلم ذلك النمرود وأبرز العقيدة الصحيحة.
When he came to go against the oppression of the king Nimrod and manifest the true belief.
وأهال على الأصنام بالكسر.
And he came and broke down those idols worship.
ولم يخش قوة ذلك الظالم.
And he did not fear the strength of that oppressor.
فتعجب القوم.
And so the people became amazed.
وقالوا من فعل هذا بآلهتنا؟
So they asked, who did this to our gods?
قالوا إنا سمعنا فتى.
They said, we heard a young person.
يذكر.
Whose name was?
يقال له إبراهيم.
Ibrahim.
وهذا سيدنا إبراهيم هو أبو الأنبياء.
And this Sayyidina Ibrahim is the father of the prophets.
وجاء بملة الإسلام.
And he came with the religion of Islam.
كما كان ممن قبله من الأنبياء على ملة الإسلام.
As the prophets before him were also on the way of Islam.
ونسب الله تعالى هذه الأمة بنوة لأبوة إبراهيم.
And Allah Ta'ala has attributed the descendants in this ummah to the father Ibrahim.
فقال ملة أبيكم إبراهيم.
So Allah says it is the way of your father Ibrahim.
إنه كان من المسلمين.
For indeed he was one of the Muslims.
فنحن في على فطرة وملة سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى شريعتي ونبوة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So we are on the way in the natural way of the religion of Ibrahim as well as the outward sacred law of our Prophet Muhammad.
وظهرت الفتوة في حياة الأنبياء كاملة.
And so فتوة became apparent in the lives of all the prophets.
بامتناعهم عن السوء.
Through their refraining from evil.
وكف الأذى.
And stopping the harm.
والامتناع لاستتباع أهواء النفس وشهواتها.
And not coming to fulfill the desires of the ego and the self.
وهم المعصومون من الله.
And these prophets are protected from sin by Allah.
فلا يتصور في حقهم أن يقعوا في شيء من معاصي الله.
And so therefore it is not conceivable in the mind that they fall into an act of disobedience.
لما راودت امرأة العزيز سيدنا يوسف.
When the wife of Al-Aziz came in order to seduce our Prophet Yusuf.
وغلقت الأبواب.
And she locked the doors.
وقالت هيت لك.
And she said, here I am.
قال معاذ الله إنه ربي أحسن مثواي.
He said, I fear Allah. Allah is the one that is going to protect.
فهنا تكون الفتوة.
This is where chivalry comes.
عندما يمنع الإنسان نفسه من الوقوع في سخط ربه.
When a person comes to stop falling into that which is going to displease his Lord.
ووقف سيدنا موسى على نبينا عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And Sayyidina Musa stood up, may Allah have peace upon him and our Prophet.
أمام الطاغية فرعون.
Before the oppressor Pharaoh.
وأظهر له الدلالات.
And he showed him the various proofs.
والعلامات القويات على صحة دعوته ونبوته.
And the strong proofs indicating his truth in prophethood.
ولكن فرعون خان نفسه.
However, فرعون tricked himself.
ووقع في رجسه.
Or he went into evil.
فحقت عليه كلمة الله سبحانه وتعالى.
And so Allah's promise came upon him.
حتى أراد أن يقتل سيدنا موسى ومن معه.
And so Pharaoh wanted to come and kill Musa and those following him.
وحصرهم عند البحر.
And so he came and trapped them at the sea.
وخاف قوم موسى.
And so the people of Musa became fearful.
وظهرت فتوة موسى.
And this is where the fatwa of Musa became apparent.
عندما قالوا إنا لمدركون.
They said, we are going to be caught.
قال كلا.
He says, no.
إنما هي ربي سيهدين.
Indeed, I have my Lord who shall guide me.
فالفتوة هنا كمال الشجاعة.
So fatwa in this circumstance is the complete bravery.
والثقة بالله سبحانه وتعالى.
And trust and dependence on Allah.
وظهرت فتوة جميع الأنبياء.
And the fatwa became apparent in the lives of all prophets.
وظهرت في النساء.
And it was also in the lives of the women.
عندما جاء سيدنا جبريل إلى سيدتنا مريم وأخبرها أنها ستحمل نبي الله عيسى.
when the angel Jibril came to give glad tidings to Maryam that she will be delivering or have a child called Isa.
فجاءت بسيدنا عيسى.
And then she came and Isa was born.
ولم تخش التهمة.
And she did not fear people saying allegations about her.
من قومها.
From her people.
لأنها طاهرة.
Because she was someone pure.
ولم تقع في المعصية.
And she never fell into sin.
فقالوا يا مريم وما كان أبوك امرأ سوء وما كانت أمك بغية.
So they said to her, O Maryam, your father was not corrupt, nor was your mother.
لما فعلت هذا؟
Why did you do this act?
وهي لم تفعل شيء.
She didn't do anything.
فأشارت إليه.
So she just pointed towards him.
قالوا كيف نكلم من كان في المهد صبية؟
Said, how are we going to speak to someone who's still in their infancy child?
فتكلم هذا الفتى.
And so this young man spoke.
سيدنا عيسى في مهده.
سيدنا عيسى in his cradle in bed.
فقال إني عبد الله.
He says, I'm the servant of Allah.
أتاني الكتاب.
Allah gave me the book.
وجعلني نبيا.
And he made me a prophet.
وجعلني مباركا أينما كنت.
And he made me blessed wherever I might be.
وأوصاني بالصلاة والزكاة ما دمت حيا.
And he commanded me with prayer and charity as long as I'm alive.
وبرا بوالدتي.
And to be righteous to my
ولم يجعلني جبارا شقيا.
To my mother. And he didn't make me an oppressor.
فذكر من آثار الفتوة وهو صبي في المهد.
And so he spoke about these characteristics of فتوة and he's still an infant.
وكانت الفتوة في سيدتنا آسيا بنت مزاحم.
And فتوة was also in our lady آسيا بنت مزاحم.
زوجة فرعون.
She was the wife of Pharaoh.
التي آمنت بموسى.
She in fact believed in موسى.
وبرب موسى.
And in the Lord of موسى.
ولم تخش فرعون.
And she didn't fear فرعون.
بل ظهرت الفتوة في ماشطة بنت فرعون.
Rather, فتوة became manifest in the one who used to comb the hair.
امرأة خادمة.
She was a servant.
فكانت تمشط لبنت فرعون خادمة في قصره.
So there was a daughter of فرعون and this lady servant used to comb the hair of the daughter of فرعون in the palace.
سقط منها المشط.
She had a comb and it fell to the ground when she.
فأخذته وقالت بسم الله.
And so she picked it up and as she was picking it up she said بسم الله.
فقالت بنت فرعون ما بسم الله.
The daughter of فرعون said what's this بسم الله.
قالت الله الذي خلقني وخلقك وخلق أبيك.
She said he is Allah the one that created me you and your father.
قالت ألك إله غير أبي.
The daughter said do you have a god other than my father.
قالت الله الذي خلقني وخلقك وخلق هو.
She said Allah is the one that created us all.
أبوك ليس بإله.
Your father is not a god.
رفع الأمر إلى فرعون.
And so فرعون received the news.
أرادوا أن يردوها ويصدوها عن دينها.
And so they desired to take her away from her religion.
ولم تخشى ذلك.
But she wasn't scared.
وكان معها طفل.
She had a baby as well.
أوقدوا لها النار.
So they lit up a fire for her.
الزيت المحمى.
With boiling oil.
وأرادوا أن يضعوها في النار.
And they came to place her in this fire.
فتثاقلت خشية على طفلها.
And so she was a bit hesitant because of her infant.
أنطق الله طفلها.
Allah allowed the child to speak.
وقال يا أمه.
And the baby said, Oh mother.
أثبتي فإنك على الحق.
Be firm indeed you are upon the truth.
ظهرت فتوتها وفتوة صبيها.
The فتوة of the mother and the child became manifest.
هذه من دلالات الفتوة.
These are signs of فتوة.
وأما كمالاتها.
As for their perfections.
فهي لرسول الله محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
For the messenger of Allah, Muhammad.
رب أمته على الفتوة.
He trained his ummah upon فتوة.
أخرج أقواما كانوا يأكلون الجيف.
He took people out of this world that used to come and eat that which was dead.
ويعيدون البنات.
And they would bury the girls alive.
ويظلم بعضهم بعضا.
And they would oppress each other.
ويحجر بعضهم بعضا بالأنساب والأحساب.
And they would insult each other with lineage and so on.
فقوم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هؤلاء القوم.
And so the prophet came and rectified their situation.
حتى صاروا قادة.
Until they became leaders.
لهذا العالم.
For this world.
نتبرك بذكر أسمائهم.
We seek blessing by mentioning their names.
لولا رسول الله لما كانوا.
Were not for the messenger of Allah, they wouldn't have been.
ورباهم ورب هذه الأمة على هذه القواعد الجليلة.
He trained them and the ummah upon these noble principles.
وذكرنا الله تعالى بجماعة آمنوا بسيدنا عيسى.
And Allah reminds us about a group of people who believed in the way of سيدنا عيسى.
في زمن الرومان.
They were under the Roman Empire.
وحاكمهم الظالم دقيانوس.
Dikyanos was an impressive ruler who was over their land.
فهربوا منه.
And so they escaped.
حتى أووا إلى الكهف.
Until they arrived at some cave.
وبقوا في ذلك الكهف سنوات طويلة.
And they remained in this cave for many many years.
يراعيهم الله.
Allah took care of their affairs.
ويقلبهم الله.
And Allah would move them.
ويحفظهم الله.
Allah would protect them.
لما؟
Why?
لأنهم فتية آمنوا بربهم وزادهم سبحانه وتعالى هدى.
Because they were fitna, a group of young men who believed in their Lord, and Allah increased them in guidance.
ومن أوى إلى كهف محمد.
And the one who comes to the cave of Muhammad.
وإلى شريعته وآدابه.
And his sacred law and his beautiful manners.
كان من جنس هؤلاء الفتية.
Will be from amongst these fitya.
الذين يتولى الله تعالى رعايتهم.
Those whom Allah takes care of their affairs.
فلا بد أن يكون لنا نصيبا عظيما من هذه الفتوة.
Therefore, we indeed are in need of a great portion of this فتوة.
وأن نربي أبناءنا وبناتنا ونساءنا وأنفسنا على هذا الوصف العظيم.
And to train us and our children and our women on this noble characteristic.
حتى لا تلتهمنا الفتن.
So that we may not be swayed by these trials.
الشرقية والغربية.
Coming from the east and the west.
والشيطانية والنفسية.
Coming from the devils and the ego.
بل نلزم قدم الاتباع على سنن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Rather we bind our steps upon the path of the messenger of Allah.
نتحلى بصفات أهل الفتوة.
And we embody the characteristics of the people of فتوة.
أعظم هذه الصفات.
The greatest of these characteristics.
كما قال سيدنا جعفر الصادق.
As Sayyidina Ja'far al-Sadiq says.
هي كف الأذى.
It is to stop harm.
لا تؤذي أحدا من الخلق.
Don't harm any creature.
لم يجوز لك أن تؤذيه.
It's not permissible for you to harm them.
لا آبا ولا أمهات ولا جيران ولا أخوان ولا أخوات ولا أبناء ولا بنات.
No mothers, fathers, children, neighbors, brothers, sisters, anyone.
بل ولا الكافر.
In fact, not even the disbeliever.
لا يجوز لنا أن نؤذيه.
You're not permitted to.
بغير حق.
Without rights.
إلا إذا كان كافرا حربيا أراد أن يتسلط على المسلمين فهذا ليس لنا معه إلا السلاح والقتال.
Unless this was a disbeliever who wages arms and war against the Muslims, and there is no way for the Muslims except to go out and take arms and defend themselves.
أما غير هؤلاء فلا.
As for other than this.
وقد قال صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said.
في حق قتل الكافر بغير حق.
When a person would, if they were to kill a disbeliever without due right.
أنه أمر شنيع.
This is something that is awful.
وأشنع من ذلك قتل المسلم.
And worse than this is the killing of a Muslim.
بغير حق.
Without right.
قال من قتل ذميا أو معاهدا فعليه لعنة الله والملائكة والناس أجمعين لا يقبل الله منه صرفا ولا عدلا يعني فرضا ولا نفلا ما يقبل الله منه شيء.
Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says a person who takes the life without right of a non-Muslim citizen within the Islamic State or someone upon whom we have entered into an alliance and a treaty with, then the curse of Allah and the angels and the believers will be upon them, and Allah will not accept any deed, whether it be a obligation or a recommended deed from them.
والفتوه تعلمنا كف الاذى حتى عن الحيوان.
And Futuwa also teaches us to refrain harming even animals.
غير المأمور بقتله.
Unless we are called to kill a particular animal.
أمرنا بقتل بعض الحيوانات المضرة.
There are some harmful animals that we've been instructed, yes, to take their lives.
كالحية والعقرب والحدأ والفار هذه فيها مضار على البشرية.
Such as a scorpion or a snake or a mouse, some of these animals which may harm people.
ما دامت فيها مضار لماذا خلقها الله تعالى؟
So if they are harmful these animals, then why did Allah create them?
لحكم كثيرة.
For many wisdoms.
حتى يستدل الإنسان بخوفه من هذه الحية أن يقع في حياة النار في النار التي فيها الحياة يوم القيامة.
Such that the human being can think, oh, I don't want to be harmed by this snake, so that way I don't be harmed by the snakes of the next life.
هذا الوجود أقامه الله تعالى على حكم.
Allah established this world with wisdoms.
قد تنكشف لبعض الناس وقد لا تنكشف.
They may be unveiled for some over others.
فلا يجوز أن نؤذي ولو أي حيوان لن نؤمر بقتله.
So it is not permissible for us to harm any creature unless we've been instructed to kill them.
ولما سئل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
When the Prophet was asked.
عن امرأة كانت تصلي.
There was a woman who used to pray.
مسلمة.
She was a Muslim.
لكنها أخطأت في حق حيوان.
However, she oppressed a animal.
حبست هرة.
She encaged a cat.
فلم تطعمها ولم تتركها تأكل في خشاش الأرض.
She didn't give food to this cat, and she didn't release this cat outside so it could find its own food.
حتى ماتت هذه الهرة.
Until that cat died.
يوم القيامة.
On the day of rising.
يدخلها الله النار.
Allah will bring her to the hellfire.
بسبب هذه الهرة.
As a result of this cat.
فالذين يتشددون بحقوق الحيوان.
And so those who do not fulfill the rights of animals.
قد سبقكم سيد الأكوان بإقامة حقوق الإنسان والحيوان.
The master of creation advanced you in fulfilling the rights of human beings and animals.
فالفتوات كف الأداء.
And so futuwa is to refrain harming.
هذه مرتبة عامة.
This is a general degree.
أعلى منها.
Beyond this.
بذل النداء.
Is to go and to give good.
أن تعطي من حرمك.
To give the one that prevents you.
وأن تصل من قطعك.
And those that sever relations with you, then you extend good relations.
بكل مستطاع.
Everything that you can of effort.
تبذل الأداء النداء بالابتسامة.
You give good with even a smile.
تبذل النداء بحسن الأخلاق.
You give good with good characteristics.
بالسلام.
With giving a greeting.
بالمصافحة.
With the handshake.
بالمال.
With your money.
بالهدية.
With a gift.
بالعطية.
With anything that you offer.
هذه أخلاق أهل الفتوة.
These are the manners of the people of Futuwa.
فلا بد أن تبرز في هذه الأمة.
This should manifest in this ummah.
أن يكفوا أذاهم ويبذلوا نداهم.
That they don't harm others and they also give their good.
لما سئل سيدنا علي كرم الله وجهه عن الفتوة.
سيدنا علي was asked about futuwa.
قال في هذا الأمر الفتوة خدمة الإخوان.
He said that the futuwa is to be in the service of your brothers.
ومواصلة الجيران.
And to have good relation with your neighbors.
أن تكون في خدمة أخيك.
To be in the service of your brother.
وفي معونته.
And his support.
فتأتيك معونة ممن؟
And then where is support going to come from then?
من الله.
Not from Allah.
من الله في عون العبد ما دام العبد في عون أخيه.
Allah will be in the support of the servant as long as the servant is in support of his brother.
فيأتيك التأييد من الله تعالى.
And this is where Allah's support comes to you.
هذه عقلية المؤمن.
This is the mindset of the believer.
المتبع للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Who is following the prophet.
القوانين الأرضية أرادت أن تسرق مننا هذه المواريث النبوية.
These civil laws in these worlds come to try and take us away from the prophetic characteristics.
وعمقت في أتباعها.
And it's placed in their followers.
خلق الأنانية.
A sense of selfishness.
حتى يعيش الإنسان في هذه الدنيا لنفسه.
So people only live fulfilling their individual needs.
فظهرت الآثار السيئة لذلك.
And so the negative traits became apparent.
وقامت العلاقات بين الناس على المصالح.
And relationships were established between people based on their own desire.
إن كانت لي مصلحة مع فلان أحسنت المعاملة معه.
If I have a need with someone, then I'll have a good relationship.
وإن لم تكن لي معه مصلحة لم ألتفت إليه.
And if there's nothing I need from them, I'm not going to be concerned with them.
هذه أخلاق وضعية.
These are mundane laws.
ساقطة سافلة.
They are abased, they are wrong.
أساسها أن الإنسان ينظر إلى مصلحة نفسه فحسب.
The human being in these cases only looking to their own benefit.
وأنه يعيش لها.
And as though he's only living for his own benefit.
والفارق بينها وبين النظرة العالية.
And the difference between this and that honorable mindset.
أنك أيها المؤمن تعيش في هذه الدنيا لله.
Is that you, O believer, live in this world for the sake of Allah.
وكل شيء تبذله لله.
And everything that you expend in effort is for Allah.
تعطي لله.
You give for Allah.
وتمنع لله.
And you prevent for Allah.
حينئذ تستكمل حقائق الإيمان.
In this way, you shall complete the realities of faith.
الحقيقة التي قررها القرآن.
The reality which has been established in the Quran.
قل إن صلاتي.
Say, indeed my prayer.
ونسكي.
And my worship.
ومحياي.
And my life.
ومماتي.
And my death.
لله رب العالمين.
Is for Allah, sustainer of the universe.
فالذي يعيش لله.
The one who lives for Allah.
تظهر منه نتائج عجيبة في واقع حياته.
Amazing results manifest in his life.
فهو كالعافية للبدن.
He is like a well-being for the body.
وكالشمس للأرض.
And like the sun for the earth.
هكذا قال الإمام أحمد في وصف شيخه الإمام الشافعي.
This is how Imam Ahmad described his teacher Imam al-Shafi'i.
الإمام الشافعي تحلى بحلية الفتوة.
Imam al-Shafi'i embodied the cloak of futuwa.
العالية.
Which was noble.
فكان كثير الخدمة.
And so he used to be in service of others.
ناشرا للعلم.
Spreading knowledge
وللدعوة
and the way to Allah
وللنور
and light.
لهذا قال الإمام أحمد عنه هذا الوصف.
For this reason, Imam Ahmad described him.
فهل يستغني الجسد عن العافية؟
Is a body able to live without good health?
وهل تستغني الدنيا عن الأرض؟
Can the earth not have the sun?
لا.
No.
كذلك نحن لا نستغني عن أهل الفتوة.
Likewise, we cannot be without the people of futuwa.
لو ذهبوا عنا لاختل الميزان.
If they disappear, the scale becomes imbalanced.
وظهرت البلايا في الناس.
And tribulations will manifest amongst people.
النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لما كان أكمل الناس فتوة.
When the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was the most perfect of people of futuwa.
ليست فتوته في الدنيا فحسب.
His futuwa was not only in this world.
بل حتى في برزخه الشريف.
Rather even in his grave interspace.
وأعظم من ذلك في يوم القيامة.
Beyond this, it will be on the day of rising.
في برزخه الشريف يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم كما ورد في الحديث حياتي خير لكم ومماتي خير لكم.
In the life of his graves, he, as the hadith mentions, my life is good for you and my death is good.
حياتي خير لكم تحدثون ويحدث لكم حصلت لكم قضية أنا أعالجها وأبين لكم الحكم.
In my life, if an affair comes to you, then you come to me and I'll resolve it.
ومماتي خير لكم أي حاله في البرزخ قال تذنبون وأستغفر لكم.
And my death is good for you because whilst I'm in the life of the graves, when you perform wrong, I will ask Allah's forgiveness for you.
مشغول بنا صلى الله عليه وسلم حتى في البرزخ.
He's busy for us even in his life of the graves.
ما أرحمه وما أكرمه.
How merciful and how noble he is.
بل أعظم من ذلك.
Rather greater than this.
يوم القيامة.
On the day of resurrection.
يوم يفر المرء من أخيه وأمه وأبيه وصاحبته وبنيه لكل امرئ منهم يومئذ شأن يغنيه.
A day in which a person will leave his parents and children and his partners because he has an affair that is overtaking him.
حتى الأنبياء والرسل عليهم صلوات الله وسلامه يقولون نفسي نفسي لأملك غيرها.
Even the prophets and the messengers on the day of resurrection will say, myself, myself, I have nothing else to worry about.
وحبيبكم محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم كما ورد في الصحيحين ماذا يقول؟
And your beloved Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, as has been come in the two authentic collections, what does he say?
يقول أمتي أمتي.
He says, my community, my community.
فهل ترى أحدا من أهل الفتوة كسيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم؟
Do you see anyone from the people of Futuwa that are comparable to our master Muhammad?
وهل يجوز لنا أن نتبع أحدا غيره؟
And is it permissible for us to follow anyone other than him?
لا والله.
No, by Allah.
ليس في ذلك الغير خير.
There is no good in other than him.
بل الخير كله عند البشير النذير صلى الله عليه وسلم.
All good is entirety is with the one who brought the glad
tidings. والسراج المنير.
And who was the blazing lamp.
فإذا أردنا أن نحقق أوصاف الفتوة.
If we wish to realize the characteristics of futuwa.
فلندرس حياة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Then we should study the life of the Prophet.
دراسة وافية.
A deep study.
ندرسه لتستقيم العقول.
We study it in order to make our intellects upright.
ولتطمئن القلوب.
And to the hearts finding tranquility.
وليحصل الخير.
And for good to arise.
فينا وفي من حوالينا.
In our lives and those around us.
حتى ننزل هذه التعاليم النبوية.
Such that we bring these prophetic teachings.
واقعا في حياتنا.
Practically in our lives.
ليس مجرد تصورات.
They are not just theories.
أو قراءة.
Or just reading.
بل لابد أن يكون النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم معنا يعيش في كل حياتنا.
We need the Prophet alive in our lives with us.
يعيش معنا في بيوتنا.
Living with us in our homes.
وتمتلأ هذه البيوت بالسنن النبوية.
And these homes become filled with the prophetic practices.
يكون معنا في نطقنا.
He should be with us in our speech.
يكون معنا في نظرنا.
He is with us in our gazing.
يكون معنا في مدارسنا.
He will be with us in our schools.
يكون معنا في أعمالنا.
Even in our workplaces.
وفي وظائفنا.
And in our employment.
بل يكون معنا في شوارعنا وفي ملاعبنا لا يفارقنا صلى الله عليه وسلم فبهذا يكون تكون الفتوة عندنا قائمة ومستقيمة.
And he also is with us in our sporting clubs, in our parks, in all places, and in this way, futuwa will become established in our lives.
فكمال الفتوة هو حسن الخلق.
The complete perfection of futuwa is good character.
وأكمل الناس أخلاقا رسول الله محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And the most perfect of people in manners is our Messenger Muhammad.
قال عنه سبحانه وتعالى وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم.
Allah describes him in the Quran by saying, and indeed you, O Muhammad, are without doubt upon an exalted character.
كمال هذه الأخلاق.
The completion of these characteristics.
يرجع إلى التقوى.
Returns to God-fearing and consciousness.
إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم.
Indeed, the most noble of you in the sight of Allah are those who have most taqwa.
وهو قال عن نفسه صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And the Prophet said about himself.
والله إني لأخشاكم وأتقاكم لله.
By Allah, I fear Allah and know Allah more than any of you.
فتحقيق الفتوة إنما يكون بالسير في طريق التقوى للوصول إلى مرتبة الاستقامة.
So through the path of taqwa, arriving to the station of uprightness is the path of futuwa.
الاستقامة هي الثبات على التقوى.
Steadfastness is to be upright in God consciousness.
وللوصول إلى هذه المرتبة العالية.
And to arrive to this elevated station.
نمشي ونسير في طريق التقوى.
We walk and travel in the path of God consciousness.
بعد الوقوع في المعصية لابد أن نرجع إلى التوبة.
If we fell into an act of disobedience, we must return to repentance.
ونمتنع عن هذه المعصية.
And we must refrain from that sin.
ما عشنا في هذه الدنيا.
As long as we are in this world.
مع الندم على فعلها الماضي.
We have regret for what we did before.
والحرص على تركها في المستقبل.
And ready to leave it in the future.
فحينئذ.
At that point.
نحقق التقوى.
We fulfill this repentance.
فإذا ثبتنا على ذلك.
And if we are strong on this.
وصلنا إلى الاستقامة.
We will arise after taqwa to uprightness.
وفي الاستقامة سقيا للقلوب وللأرواح وللأسرار.
And in that level of steadfastness, you will nourish your soul, your heart, and your secret.
وأن لو استقاموا على الطريقة لأسقيناهم ماء غدقا.
Allah says, and if they were steadfast on the path, then we would grant them fresh water.
فالآية التي تجمع علم الطريق للوصول إلى التقوى والتحقيق.
And so the verse that combines the path that will lead you to full reality
هي قوله سبحانه وتعالى
is Allah saying
وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى.
As for the one who fears the station of his Lord and refrains from fulfilling the desires of the ego, then this is the one who will have those two gardens.
كيف تمنع نفسك وتهزمها عندما تريد أن تخالف أمر ربها؟
How can you stop fulfilling your desires when it wants to go against the command of your Lord?
تخوفها بالله.
You make it fearful by Allah.
وغضب الله وسخط الله.
And through the anger and displeasure of Allah.
لا يساويه غضب أحد من الخلق.
There's nothing equivalent to Allah's displeasure.
فتنهى هذه النفس عن هواها.
Refrain this ego from fulfilling its desires.
وعن غيها.
And from its bad ways.
فتذكرها بالمآلات الحسنة.
Remind your ego with good consequences.
أن المأوى إلى الجنة.
That your refuge will ultimately be in paradise.
وإلى الرضوان.
And the pleasure of Allah.
وإلى رب غير غضبان.
And to a Lord that is not displeased.
هذه الفتوة.
This is indeed futuwa.
وشيئا من علاماتها ودلالاتها.
And some signs of the futuwa.
نسأل الله تعالى.
We ask Allah exalted.
أن يجعلنا وإياكم من أهلها.
To make us and you from amongst its people.
من خواص أهلها.
From its elect people.
أن يحلينا بكل زين.
And to ennoble us with all good traits.
وأن يخلينا عن كل شيء.
And to leave all bad traits away from us.
يعظم لنا سبحانه وتعالى الاتباع لنبيه الزين.
May Allah magnify our following for the beautiful prophet.
ويقوينا على ذلك.
And to strengthen us on this path.
ويوفقنا لذلك.
And to allow us to succeed.
أن يرزقنا التوبة.
To grant us repentance.
والتقوى.
And
والثبات عليها في الاستقامة.
And steadfastness.
أن يحيينا على ذلك ويتوفانا على ذلك.
May he revive us on this and allow us to die on that.
يحفظنا من جميع المهالك.
And protect us from all harm.
يسلك بنا خير المسالك.
And to allow us to follow the best of paths.
مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم
with the Prophet peace be upon him
وأصحابه
and his companions
وأتباعه
his followers
ومحبيهم
and his lovers
وجعلنا وياكم من خواصهم
and make us of the inner circle
بخير ولطف وعافية وإلى حضرة النبي.
فتحيا حياة ما كما تلك حيوتي.